Tonight is night 4. Can you believe we've been doing Vacation Bible School for 4 days already? Well, we are excited for you to learn and listen to a new story today. And I wonder, how's your Bible verse going? Did you almost have it memorized? Keep working and get ready for a new craft and a fun activity for your family tonight. Well, before we get started, maybe you should stretch your arms up and get them ready so that you can sing our song. Here we go.
My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty.
Sorry
to I'm sorry that these people hurt you. But maybe I've got a story that can help you. Maybe I can talk to you about the story of Noah. Noah was a man.
You know what? I know the story of Noah. Don't bother.
Okay, but like, hear me out, okay?
Alright.
He went through things just like you are.
Did Noah not build an ark? I'm trying to play volleyball here.
I know. He built a boat. You're playing volleyball. I get it. But he had a pretty big job to take too. And he knew that God chose him to build that boat.
Mm-hmm.
And do you think that everyone was on board with it? I mean, a lot of people thought he was crazy. And a lot of people said not very nice things to him. Mm-hmm. And it was hard for him to listen to all of that, those mean things. But he still went through with it, and he was still obedient, and he still followed through. He pushed through those obstacles just like you can. And sometimes, and God blessed him so much for it. Mm-hmm. And I think that you will be too. Renee, people are gonna say mean things. God put you on our team for a reason. Mm-hmm. And I know sometimes it's hard, but maybe just don't let what they say get to you.
Yeah, wow. I really needed to hear that story about Noah. I guess I kind of forgot about all the obstacles he had to overcome to do that big job that God gave him.
Yeah. And Jesus also says that we should pray for those that hurt us. So maybe we can pray that God opens the eyes of the people that hurt your feelings. And you know what? I'll also pray for you. And I'll pray that he gives you strength and courage to keep going.
Thanks. Hey, Claire, would you pray for us, pray for me before we go as a team and get started today?
Yeah, for sure. God, I thank you for this great team that we're on, and I thank you that you're going to just bless us with our game coming up and that today's practice goes well, and I just ask that you strengthen Renee to keep doing what she's meant to do, and you keep us all safe out on the court, and we have a great day today. In Jesus' name, amen.
All right, I'm feeling better. Let's go to practice.
Yeah, I think they're starting.
Awesome. Woo!
We did it!
Wow, that feels so good.
We won!
Oh, wow, that was an amazing game.
We won.
So good.
How are you feeling?
You know what, I'm feeling better. Hearing that story about how Noah, like, people made fun of him and teased him too, and with God's help, he was able to sort of put that behind him and be obedient, and that was really helpful. Thanks.
Good. I'm really glad that helped you. And I hope you guys find encouragement in it too.
Mm-hmm.
And you know what? I think it might be a great time for us to go over our week's Bible verse.
That's right.
So, let's all read it together. It's from Ephesians 4, verse 16. Let's say it together.
God makes the whole body fit together perfectly. As each part does its own special work, it helps the other parts grow.
As we learned about the obstacles that we go through, tonight's challenge is actually a physical obstacle course.
Ooh, cool.
But there's a catch. It's blindfolded.
Ooh,
so,
that's tricky.
Here's what you have to do. You get to create your own obstacle course. You can do it outside. You can use chairs. You can use skipping ropes. You can use balls. But one at a time, you're going to be blindfolded, and everyone else has to help you, has to talk you through how to get through your obstacle course.
That's awesome.
Remember to stay safe and make sure that it's not too crazy so no one gets hurt, but we want you to have so much fun with it, and make sure you send us videos so we can see it too.
That's right. Tag the church so we can watch you go through your obstacle course. That's awesome.
I think it's going to be so fun.
It will be. Now, the craft for tonight is going to help you do your obstacle course, and maybe you should do your craft first. We're making foam fingers of encouragement.
Cool.
And so dig inside your kit and find those fun foam hands, and you can write an encouraging word and cheer on your family as they go through the obstacle course.
That's a great idea.
Awesome. Well, before we go tonight, we want to close in prayer. Mm-hmm. Let's pray together. God, we thank you so much for your word. We thank you for the story of Noah that I learned today in a special way. You had given him a job to do, and he was trying to be obedient to you. And you know what, God, there were people who were just mean. And sometimes when we go to school or go other places, Lord, people say unkind things to us, and they're mean to us.
Mm-hmm.
So Lord, I pray that you would help each one of our kids remember the story of Noah, that even though he faced some big obstacles, you were with him and you encouraged him and you helped him to get the job done. God, thank you, Lord, for each one of our families tonight, and I pray that you would bless them in their homes as they have fun together and work together. We pray all these things in your name. Amen.
Amen.
See you tomorrow night.
See ya.